evening, everybody. I am Dr. Sulochana Vasudevan. I work as a senior project advisor in National Mission for Empowerment of Women. You must have heard about that, under the Ministry of Women and Child, Government of India. Presently, I am posted on a project called Priyadarshini, a livelihood promotion project for women. Empowerment and livelihood promotion project for women. I had to honestly confess, I do not know much about ICT. Okay. But I have learned quite a lot after hearing your presentation and after hearing his presentation as well. I wanted to react to some of your issues and how we have managed in National Mission for Empowerment of Women, how we tackled some of the problems which you people have expressed. One is that I wanted to say that information sharing between civil society organization and government. The National Resource Center for Women under the National Mission for Empowerment of Women was precisely set up for this purpose. Okay, it will, besides undertaking research work, it will also have information sharing, data sharing with civil society organizations and vice versa. Okay, we have created a web portal, you can visit us in the web portal, and where we have uploaded all our achievements so far. But we also solicited information from the civil society organization also, so that a pool of data is available at one place where everybody can access. In the National National Mission for Empowerment of Women and the National Resource Center for Women, we've also set up a state resource center for women at the state level, headed by the state mission authority is headed by chief minister of the state. Okay. There also, they are supposed to be doing this data collection, data uploading, information sharing, and undertaking innovative pilot projects, okay, and converging various programs and schemes of various departments with the grassroots. Okay, so what I am telling you all here is that any innovative efforts that you people are doing, kindly post your case study to us so that we can upload. It will be a form of information sharing to all of you. But we have also asked this, one of the problems many of you have expressed is that content and translation into a local language. So the state resource centers are there, which are precisely meant to do this. But if they don't have expertise, they can always ask the local NGOs to help them to translate. That is the kind of understanding. For example, recently we have developed Ahimsa Messenger Kit, which will give information on legal recourse available for women. Okay, and then we've also developed Gender Atlas, inclusiveness, you people have said, inclusiveness, Gender Atlas. But these are all in English language. So who is going to take it to the grassroots level in the different regions of the country, knowing the cultural context and the regional differences in the language and all. So we've asked our state resource centers to translate with the help of the NGOs who are willing to do it, and with the local language department, translate it and upload in the website. We've also asked them to create their own website and interlink with the National Resource Center website so that the data is available both at the regional level and at the state level. Okay. Another thing is that we are also trying to explore the use of community radios as innovative pilot project. For your information, I'd like to mention that we have commissioned 52 innovative pilot projects. 47 are in operation. And based on the information that we solicited on the website, people have applied, and innovative projects we have commissioned. So that includes violence against women, judicial system, that talks about livelihood promotion, behavior change communication. So one such project we are also doing with IT for Change. They are implementing a project in Purna Shakti Kendra using ICT information and using Panchayat effectively. So she is the best person to talk about that. Perhaps if time permitting, she can talk. And what we have done that, we have grouped the NGOs into different categories. Those NGOs who have been doing on violence against women, those NGOs who are doing work on livelihood promotions. So we have asked them to share the information, whatever the tools and techniques that they are developing, through the internet. so that the information is available and they don't duplicate the efforts. So that is going on, but these are all only small scale initiatives, but the same thing has to be replicated at the national level. So why, what I mean to say is it, the National Resource Center for Women and the National Mission for Empowerment of Women is exactly doing the same. Data demystification of data, people, one of the group has also presented about demystification of data. So we have asked our Purna Shakti Kendras at the grassroots level, that is a one-stop center for information sharing and giving access to women for their entitlements and linking up with various service programs and services at the grassroots level. We have told our district facilitation come resource center to organize focus group discussion. Besides that, what is that I said here? Community, what I am forgetting. No, no, not focus group audits. Discussion. Yeah. No, not PRI. Audits. No, not audits. Okay, a sort of a focus group discussion, where we have said, with the women's groups, with the women's group, all the stakeholders you bring together and do consultations. In that, we have said, you have to use both qualitative and quantitative data, you capture and put it in the website, in the district level website, because at the grassroots level, still such technologies have not percolated down. Okay? They are still using only the cameras to capture the data, they are entering in the forms only. So that goes to the district level center where they put it in the website and that comes to the national center. So qualitative and quantitative data is disseminated this form only. Unless and until the digital system is going to reach the grassroots level, this kind of a transformative changes which is happening at the grassroots level. It is happening. Don't say it's not happening. Beautifully it's happening, but there is nobody to document it. Nobody is to upload it in the website to share the such information. So our experiences in organizing this Narika Chaupal, that is what the word I wanted to tell you, Narika Chaupal at the grassroots level, where all the women are brought together and on each and every issues of women are discussed with them. And they come out with suggestions. And these suggestions are taken to the panchayats. Okay? So these have to be documented and these documentations should be available for a wider outreach. Okay? And then another thing that I wanted to say is that you are talking about domestic surveillance and also ongoing support to community-led technology. So in one of the innovative pilot project with which we are doing with Hand in Hand, an NGO, a Chennai-based NGO, but they have moved to Pali in Rajasthan, and they have set up a citizen center. Where in the citizen center, they've trained the women in operating computers, and those people have become the resource agents for training other women. And also using the mobile technology. And then taking photocopying, printout from photocopier, using identity card, preparing identity card. All these things, the women themselves have done it. So the citizen center has become a technology hub for us. And then many women access at the citizen center and they've also learned computer technology. So when you talk about a community-led initiative, this could be one of the initiative, and similar such efforts have to be created in every village. Only then the women will be able to access technology. Otherwise, till now the technology has not reached villages. Yet another initiative I would like to talk about is that in under a project of comprehensive empowerment of women, through e-Vidya project, which we have done in 7 states covering 15 districts on a pilot basis, okay, in which the adolescent girls and women are linked with e-literacy program, where computer skill has been given, designed and given by National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, a government-based body. They have designed this, and the women and the girls were imparted ICT skills, thereby to help them livelihood promotion and income generation activities. Some 25,000 adolescent girls and women have been targeted through this. How did we select? From each of the poor household, we selected one woman or adolescent girl. Okay. So this is a very, very good project and it is a very successful project. Now the ministry is thinking of replicating this, upscaling this project, because the evaluations were also done. Evaluations is also going on and people have visited constantly to monitor the impact of this such a project. So these kind of efforts are possible. And then yet another initiative that I would like to say is grievance redressal mechanisms. Okay, you people were talking about that. We have a computer-based system to talk about grievance redressal, and immediately the redressal is given. For example, sexual harassment at workplace, the act says within 90 days the grievances should be addressed, and this is happening. It's not this thing, it's a mandatory process for the bodies to act upon. For example, many women are coming into workforce now in organized and unorganized sector. So this sexual harassment at workplace acts as a deterrent. And in each of the office, they have to set up a committee. And then here the grievance redressal mechanism. But how does it happen at the grassroots level? Local complaints committee is being set up. At the district level also it has been set up. And then where the district magistrate or one of the senior officials will be officiating that. Take a hearing the complaints and they will dispose of the complaint. And employer is also supposed to give. How all these things can become ICT based? See, this is what is very critical. Those women who do not want to appear before a committee, okay, and show their face, how it can the technology can transfer this kind of a grievance mechanisms also needs to be explored. And then recently, the government is contemplating bringing out a scheme called Beti Bachao, Beti Bada, which is an empowerment and education scheme for girl child. And through a mass campaign, we are planning to bringing the girl children to school, not only that, but also to positively promote child sex ratio. The child sex ratio is declining. Positive promotion of child sex ratio. This is because the National Mission for Empowerment of Women has done a project where improved child sex ratio action plan was evolved for 100 gender critical districts, and this is also going to happen in 100 gender critical districts where CSR is also very high. Mass campaign, all multimedia campaign will be used to address this issue. So this national action plan has led to this Beti Bachao Beti Badao campaign, and recently the Prime Minister Modi has also announced it in a speech. It's a multi-sectoral action, so all kinds of communication technology will come into play. 100 critical districts, but based on the success of this, other parts of the country also will be reached. The total cost of the scheme is about 200 crores. This is on the pipeline, anytime it will be launched. And then another initiative that we are contemplating just now is that Nirbhaya Center, one stop center which the ministry is planning to launch in every district across the country. What it will do, it will facilitate access to wide variety of services for women. You are all talking about services not reaching the women. The services, wide variety of services which include medical aid, police assistance, legal counseling, psychosocial counseling, and temporary shelter to women affected by violence. Not only that, how all these things can be linked with technology, that needs to be explored. Because centers, having a center is not enough. How many women access this? How many cases have been disposed? How many police assistance, legal counseling has done? All this information database has to be there. So it has to be linked up. And then under strengthening mechanisms for combating violence against women, the government is also planning to launch a scheme which is also on the pipeline, which aims to provide support to women affected by violence by establishing quality care mechanisms for emergency as well as long-term rehabilitation, facilitating linkages with existing services, with existing women helplines, okay, and then introducing new measures of preventing violence and promoting replication of good practices across the country. So if you have done good practices, share with us. So that can be upscaled, okay. And all existing as well as provisional schemes such as Women Helpline, implementation of Domestic Violence Act and restorative justice for rape victims will be integrated under the scheme. So already the government has written to IT department for giving a number of 181 for Women Helpline across the country. So we are awaiting the response. Now she is showing me the time is up, so I'll leave it here. If anything more that you wanted to know, we can respond. But in conclusion, I would like to say that there is a plethora of scheme that the Ministry of Women and Child Government of India is implementing. But we have to, other than the website information, we have no technology upgradation in all this. ICT and all has not been used. Only website information, we put the data in the website. And whoever wants to access, we are doing it. But other than that, there is no other improved technology that we are accessing, because the services are not available at the village to get the information from the village level. That's all. Thank you.